Antarctica looks pure white, but here, the glacier is bleeding. This is bloodfalls, a real crimson waterfall pouring from the Taylor Glacier in the McMurdo Dry Valleys. When the water first emerges, it isn't red at all. It's a concentrated, iron-rich brine. Once it hits the air, the iron oxidizes, forming rust-like iron oxides that stain the ice a shocking red. Recent research shows that the color comes from iron-rich nanospheres, not dissolved iron minerals or crystalline iron. This water comes from a trapped subglacial pool, sealed beneath the glacier for millions of years. It also harbors ancient, low-oxygen microbes that have survived in complete darkness, without oxygen or sunlight, for millennia. Long ago, this area was a fjord, and as sea levels dropped and glaciers advanced, the seawater became trapped beneath the ice. So why doesn't this water freeze in Antarctica's extreme cold? There are two key reasons: high salinity and heat released during freezing. The brine is 2 to 3 times saltier than ocean water, which lowers its freezing point dramatically. And as some water freezes, it releases heat, warming the surrounding brine and allowing it to keep flowing, like its own natural antifreeze system. This is why bloodfalls continues to pour year-round without freezing. In 1911, geologist Thomas Griffith Taylor discovered bloodfalls. The presence of ancient life in this extreme, oxygen-deprived environment gives us clues about how life might survive beneath the icy oceans of other planets, like Mars or Europa. So no, Antarctica isn't bleeding. It's revealing ancient secrets that could even change how we think about life in the universe.